Hello students, welcome to the lecture series of Building and Town Planning. Today we are going to discuss about GIS tools for town planning. We have seen that town planners uses computers to record and analyze the information and prepare the reports and recommendations. The computer data sheets, spreadsheets and analytical techniques which are widely used to project cost and forecast for future trends in employment, housing, transportation and population. At the same time, the computerized geographical information system enables planners to map areas and overlay various maps with geographical variables like population density, and to combine it and manipulate the geographical information to produce alternative plans for land use and for future development. This combination of technology like preparing data sheets or spreadsheet and at the same time taking the geographical information system of any territory is nothing but GIS. So let us start with the use of GIS in town planning. Topics to be covered in these sessions are GIS and its introduction, function of GIS through 4 M's, benefits of GIS in using town planning, use of GIS in urban planning. And at last, we will have certain examples of prepared maps in particularly ArcGIS software. So the question is, what is GIS and how this tool is useful in town planning? So the GIS comprises with three terms, that is geographical information system. G stands for geographical, which is the physical feature located on Earth's surface. By featuring the coordinates and its independent like latitude, longitude and the elevation. I stands for information which is useful in the form of tables, graphics, images and maps or charts. This can be of ready-made information or we have to obtain from the physical data and the analysis has been done. And the last is system. The software having interlink between the components with different functional capabilities for data inputs, edit, combination, queries and outputs, which includes nothing but modeling. The data which can be derived from the physical features and in the form of tables, this will be analyzed in particular software system. This is the place where all the manipulation of data sheets has been done, and the combination of those geographical data as well as those spreadsheet data is inserted and that output has been come up. Thus, it is the system designed to capture, store, manipulate, analyze, manage and present all type of geographical data. A GIS stores its data in different layers. Each layer consists of a map plus a data of attribute table. Here you can see the real world image which has been captured through remote sensing and interrelated with GIS tool in terms of raster file. This raster is of land use and elevations. This elevation is of uneven, or you can say this elevation is of different forms of contours which can be studied in this raster file. In this raster file, we can create vectors. Vectors are of point, line and in terms of polygon. Here you can see in parcels you can find the dots or points. Even it is in form of line like streets. And at last, it is in the form of geographical boundaries, whether of different countries or any territory or province of a country. It can be anything, or it can be a boundary of a local town planning authority. So various administration work can be done in terms of certain boundary layers, and this data is nothing but vector data. The entire GIS tool has been analyzed in a software provided by ESRI, that is ISRI. This software is ArcGIS or ArcTool, in which you will find ArcTool. In that, these ArcTools are comprises in a software or software based application, and that is ArcGIS. This software is capable of analyzing raster file and vector file. You can import certain data from AutoCAD files. As I discussed, there are certain set of data which can be analyzed. This data is of two types, that is spatial data and non-spatial data or attribute data. Spatial data is captured in terms of raster file or raster image, which is absolute and relative to the location of geographical features, where elevation and land use has been considered. In this file, you can have certain spatial data, and that is the data of GIS tool. If you don't have any data, you can create your own data based on those images or based on that raster files, that is of non-GIS data, or you can say non-spatial data. This non-spatial data has been formed in a particular spreadsheet or data sheet, and then that is called spatial analysis and modeling tool, which ultimately used in a urban planning. And in land use planning, you can directly use those spatial data for mapping purpose, which is also part of urban planning. For example, if I take a Google image or Google Earth image, and if I import that image into GIS tool, this image is containing the geographical feature, includes hilly area, plain area, boundaries of any region, and you can map this and use as a reference for urban planning. If any detail has been required, like detailing of streets, the length of streets, then total land cover area of particular region or different wards, that can be fed in terms of non-GIS data or like attribute data, and you can edit those spreadsheet, and ultimately you can combine those map or those boundary map which has been captured from Google Earth, and you can combine those Google Earth image and the relevant information which comprises with those image, and by combination of this you can utilize those in urban planning. There are different uses of GIS tools in urban planning that we will discuss later on, but first let us understand the use of GIS. GIS is useful and powerful analytical tool for urban planning and urban management. The database management, the visualization, spatial analysis and spatial modeling is key tool for analyzing the geographical data. GIS is used for the storage of land use maps, plans, socio-economic data and planning applications. For example, if I have a Google image of 2010 and the recent image of 2020, then I can compare both the land use and how the land use has been changed. For example, at 2010, there were lesser development, so you will find lot of green area in that image. But as city expand, the green cover will be replaced by such developments, and by the image of 2020 or the recent time, you can compare those land use map, how the city has grown up or how the land pattern has changed in a particular period of time. So this is how the GIS tool is useful for land use map, for plotting the boundaries, for having all those geographical and demographical information which can be fitted in that attribute table, and ultimately you can manipulate those data and have the desired results which can be useful for future development. Then mapping provides the most powerful visualization in GIS tools. Now the functions of GIS through 4 M's. These 4 M's are of measurement, mapping, monitoring and modeling. These are the sequence which has been followed in GIS tools. For instance, in previous sessions we have studied about different surveys which has been carried out for any implementing the town planning scheme or for the betterment or the future of any national, region or any demographical feature. In that, the geographical information we have, other is the people's interest will be studied in terms of various data collection and adopting various methods for collection of data. After having such data, we will prepare a spreadsheet. This spreadsheet contains the data of a particular region. I will compare those data with the geographical feature or geographical information which is in terms of raster file, and that is of image file which contains the information of geographical features like government conduct calculation of the population in India in every 10 years, which is nothing but census of India. This data is collected in every state, in every region, in every taluka, then district, each and every town, and the, at last each and every villages and nagar panchayats. Then this will be coordinated with all those geographical data sheet. For example, if I calculate the total population of Gujarat, that is of 6.5 crore, then the total population with particular region of Gujarat is been highlighted in map, that is of 6.5 crore. Even you can feed this information in that tabular form of different states. As you go in further detail, you will get the information in the form of municipality, local urban agglomeration, small towns, statutory towns and so on. So this will be bifurcated and fitted in that particular area. So minor detailing has been done. So let us start with first is measurement. The measurement means the information of map features find their location, dimension, topographical information and all other information, which includes the area of any statutory unit or boundary of any town, the topographical and geographical features and so on. Then mapping, that is the intelligent mapping which is more than the real world. I can detail out each and every component which is actually on land. I can detail out the property in terms of various land use by occupation. This building can be of government building, commercial building, residential building. I can feed that data in terms of mapping. It can be in the form of point, line or polygon. Next is monitoring. It is very much essential for efficiently managing the resources and planning and the development of better society. This monitoring is if any alteration or change in land use or land pattern has been modified. This can be the standard example for understanding of this monitoring. Like as I said previously, if I have a map of 2010, I can visualize those maps and have those details and compare this land value change with 20, 20 maps. And this is how I can monitor the land value and land pattern as well. And the at last is modeling. It is very important feature of GIS where all the statics and dynamics information can be reproduced in the form of tables, charts and maps. This also has been discussed earlier in detail. Now the benefits of GIS in town planning. You can improvise or updation of any maps. There will be greater efficiency in retrieval of information, like you can have the population data, you can have even transport network analysis tools, even you can retrieve the data of different water bodies, any change in environment in a particular region, like you can study the impact of industries on atmosphere by temperature changing. This can be highlighted even in GIS tools. Then faster and more extensive two types of GIS to planning. This can be done in both in mapping and in attributes. Then improved analysis. These are the various tools. Even you can import such data from Excel to this attribute table. You can modify this attribute table. You can edit any feature class, or like we are inserting any rows and columns in Excel file, the similar you can do in this attribute table and manipulate the data. Then better communication to the public and staff, resource inventory, analyzing of existing resources, modeling and projection for employment, for network analysis, for traffic, for environment concern as well. And the last is development of planning options. First is you have to make the maps. In that map, if I want to highlight certain building components or highlight the building by its occupancy class, I will highlight this building as a public building. Then I will input data in terms of attribute table. This data, if I feed data in attribute table, this will be of non-spatial data. I can feed manually, and the relevant information regarding this area or regarding this building, I will input all these buildings data in terms of areas, in terms of its occupancy class, in terms of its story height. In many ways I can add in attribute table. After adding those data in attribute table, I will perform the analysis, and the new map comprises with all those details which I add in attribute will be shown. Here the land use of public building, the color highlighted by red determines the public building. The orange is of mixed land use, and thus you can bifurcate each and every building. And at last, you will present the spatial data. Now, the use of GIS in urban planning. These sectors are land use, zoning, transportation, urban design, park, walkability, census data, network analysis, greenhouse gas emission inventories, stormwater management, public consultation and engagement, and at last is visualization. At each scale of planning, there are different stages. All these scales have their own stages, like analysis of existing situation, then modeling and projection, resource inventory, development of planning options, then selection of planning options, plan implementation, plan evaluation, implementation, and at last feedback. So all this comprises various stages, whether if I'm talking about land use or zoning. Ultimately you have to gather some information, then perform certain steps, you have to finalize those data detailing. Ultimately you will gather information, implement those information in a definite way, then evaluation has been done, and at last any development or any town planning or any land use planning has been done. Let us understand by taking simple example of land use map. This is proposed zoning map of 2021 of Ahmedabad city, which has been taken from Ahmedabad DP. Here in this map, you will found different color notation with their legends like residential area, like R1 zone, R2 zone, R3 zone, Gamtal area, industrial area, walled city area, then legends for boundaries, for railways, for water bodies. Every color has its own importance and significance, which has been given in this map. So this entire map can be done by putting those geographical data or geographical features or maps. In that, I will map or I will plot boundaries of each and every unit. If I take a village like Thaltej village, then I'll plot the boundaries of Thaltej village. Furthermore, I will plot the boundaries of its extension, but later on it will be the part of AMC, or it will be in the boundary of AMC, though the village has to be highlighted. In this, first is measurement is taken of like various boundaries, Thaltej village, then there its extension will be measured. Then next is mapping. The mapping will be done in the same tool. Then at monitoring, I will feed those datas in monitoring, or any extension will be, if any expansion is been done, I will monitor that change in land use and land patterns. And at last, in terms of spatial data and the attribute data, I will combine it and I will create modeling of that particular things. So by each and every details and minor details has been plotted in terms of geography, in terms of land area, land cover and topographical feature. Even this includes physical features like river body, water body and so on. Next is the analysis of network, or you can say network analysis. Here you can see the detail map of Ahmedabad or Ahmedabad Urban Development Authority. Here one buffer has been made. This is nothing but an analytical tool providing buffer area in particular line. In this buffer area, you can find out the bicycle users in that particular area. So what is the shape of that particular area? What is the shape length? How many bicycle users or density of bicycle users? That is also fitted. So this is how you can prepare those attribute tables in ArcGIS or the software tools. Even you can see in this map, it is the similar you can see in Google Map. Just you need to connect it with internet. The software itself take its latitude and longitude, and above your map it will show the Google Earth image of that particular region. Here you can see there is a separate map of Ahmedabad and Oda with various roads. In that, I have just added the feature class of, or I have added the feature class of another layer in terms of sky view of the city, which is also one of the advantage of GIS tool. Next is network analysis. You can see here the network analysis by providing linear measurement, by providing the points from one station to another station, and you can just create the trip distribution, how one can is traveling from one place to another. That is called travel demand modeling. That is also done in GIS tool. Just you need require suitable data for analysis. This one is the pedestrian analysis of individual. You can find out in Google that how much you have traveled or how much you have covered by bicycle. The similar way, you can plot or you can just find out the route or any transport route, or you can modify those transport route by putting certain data, by adding certain feature class to that attribute table. This one is the density map. Every color shade determines the density of that particular area. The darker the color, more is the density of that particular area. So this is how you can bifurcate the census data or any relevant data. You have to just feed in that particular checkbox. That's it. Earlier, as I showed, the network analysis. Here you can see this through various models. This one is transport routes of commuters. Even you can feed the household survey data in terms of real estate property value. You have to just feed those data, that's it. This one is land use map of the city area of different region, which has been highlighted in each and every squares. You can prepare such things in ArcGIS, and this will be helpful for town planners or urban planners. The detailed land use designation given in this image. Even as I said earlier, you can feature the environment concern, you can feature for the water bodies or any natural resources. Here you can see the watershed of any particular river, and this has been shown in different categories like mean annual precipitation and the mean annual temperature. What is the temperature of that particular area and the fluctuation with river body, and the how much is the precipitation, that is also highlighted in different colors, and the legends for the same is given in the map. This one is the population density of Toronto. So all those census data can be compiled and just put it in attribute table. Geographical information, in that layer I will add just one feature class, you will get this population density map of any city. Thanks for watching this session. I hope you have learned the uses of GIS tool in town planning. Thanks.